actual transgender community is livid about. Oh, and there is a father and son gay couple who want to get married. And they're being told they can't, and they're livid about it. The son is adopted. Details coming up. First, Richard in Raleigh, North Carolina. Welcome, sir. Great to have you on the EIB Network. Hello.
It's a real pleasure, Rush. I just wanted to thank you because I'm a molecular biologist, and I was thoroughly convinced global warming was real. I thought, well, we got to do something and so on and so forth. About 3 years ago, family members suggested I start listening to you, and I did. And I thought, well, you know, I agree with just about everything Rush says, except he's got it wrong with global warming. But being a scientist, I decided, let me look at the papers. I took some meteorology courses just as a side interest, and I realized after reading the real science, I'd been lied to. They had completely deceived me. I was stunned at first, and then I got mad, and now it's one of my pet peeves on social media is I'm waging this one-man campaign to convince everybody I know that it's a hoax. It's the Greens that used to be the old Reds trying to control everything, and I couldn't believe it. I was so stunned at the enormity of the lie. That
you were able to determine this reading their own published studies, right?
Right. I went to the literature. I did my online searches, like I'd research any of my molecular biology topics. I started pulling up the papers. I had to do some generalized papers to learn the language, but then I started reading what the real scientists were publishing, and then I started seeing the stuff. And I also realized the people in the global warming group, they're not even real scientists. They've got like bachelor's degrees. They're barely qualified. Even the people advising the UN, I will look at their CVs up. These people aren't real. I mean, they're jokes. And most of them were like political hacks. And then I played the grant game. I've helped play the grant game. And you chase the money. You be as honest as you can. But, you know, it's follow the money is what it was.
You know, you said something very key here. And, you know, I should have included this in that piece I wrote for National Review. I think one of the you're using social media here. Social media is turning out to be, when used properly, a great weapon against the drive-by media. There is as much opportunity for truth and alternative. I think it's one of the reasons Carson and Trump are doing so well, actually. It can overcome lying, distorted, or non-coverage of somebody in the drive-by. I mean, Carson is using it really effectively, in fact. But Richard, I'm glad you called, and I'm glad you did what you did. You found out for yourself using